Speaking of last passes.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
I got a quick question. I want to go back to Arizona and Buffalo real quick. I was thinking, who did that last pass suck more for? Who did it hurt more for? Bills fans or Texans fans? We were talking off camera about people's calling for people's jobs. I wish the Texans would rehire Bill O'Brien just so they could fire him again. Bro, like, if you're a Texans fan, how in the world, how do you, I mean, that's got, you've taken L's twice on Sundays now. It's not just that they traded DeAndre Hopkins. It was always what they got for him or what they didn't get for him. Like, how do you end up, what was it, a second round pick and David Johnson was on IR now? I mean, my God, what a disaster. Like, that is just, that's going to go down. It was already one of the worst trades in recent memory. That's going to go down as one of the worst trades of all time because if DeAndre Hopkins and Kyler Murray improve upon their connection, this is going to go down as one of the better combinations in the NFL. Not of all time, it was too late for that, but in recent memory. And not only is DeAndre Hopkins going to finish his career, I'm full of proclamations today. Not only is he going to finish his career as one of the most prolific receivers of his era, but you want to talk about like adjusted for it. In the analytics community, we adjust for things. Even last week, it's funny, we didn't get to this, and I'm not trying to get off into this tangent, but DeAndre Hopkins said that receivers, and I guess he meant by extension quarterbacks, should get credit for DPI yardage. So I like that. You know, probably complicated, but I do like that.
I don't like that so much. I saw that last week. I don't like that.
His career should be adjusted for all the quarterbacks that he had to play for until he got with Deshaun Watson and now Kyler Murray. Like, his stats should be adjusted for garbage quarterbacks. No disrespect, but I'm disrespecting him. Like, when you look at what he's done and what he's been able to do, that's when we talk about best receivers in the league. There would be no competition when it comes to his numbers if he actually had a competent quarterback and, frankly, probably a better coach before they finally ended up with Deshaun
Watson. I'm going to answer your question. Can I answer your question? Who's the hurt?
Oh, yeah, the original question. By the way, in case you couldn't tell, it hurts worse for the Texans. The Bills are still 7-3.
No, I think it hurts worse for the Bills because as bad as the DeAndre Hopkins trade was, it was bad. Nobody's saying it in hindsight. Everybody said at the time, what are you thinking? Are you kidding me? You traded DeAndre Hopkins. You got a second-round pick back and a running back with a bad contract and injury history. So it wasn't just a bad – just not just the injuries – it's the contract as well.
And the position. It's a running back. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's a running back. Come on. You can get a running back, third round, fourth round. No problem. But as bad as that trade was, the Houston Texans, struggling right now, don't have their own first or second round picks because they made another bad trade.
Yeah.
You don't have enough bandwidth to get excited and get mad about DeAndre Hopkins because you're still saying, wow, Miami, they got a better record than us, and they own our future because Bill O'Brien just overpaid for Laremy Tunsil and Kenny Stills. And he got a bad deal when he traded Jadeveon Clowney. And another bad deal with DeAndre Hopkins. So just too many bad trades, just like a orbit, a galaxy of bad trades. But for Buffalo, poor Buffalo. Like, why does this always happen to you, Buffalo? Like, It's not a 2020 thing. That's why it hurts worse for Buffalo. This is not about the 2020 team.
It's a franchise.
It's just so much institutional memory.
So you're going to Scott Norwood. You're going
it's
to the fourth straight Super Bowl.
And it's too bad. You know what?
Forgetting where your helmet is. All of that. Okay.
Yeah, just all kinds of stuff. All kind of just drafting, inventing first round quarterbacks like
JP.
What's my man's name? I was going to say from New Orleans. He played in Tulane, right? Was it Tulane?
Tulane, yeah.
J.P.
Yeah.
Losman, E.J. Manuel.
Yeah.
Getting Drew Bledsoe too late.
They got one now, though. You can't deny it. They got a guy now. Hell, they got a triple threat quarterback. They got a dual threat quarterback that can catch touchdown passes now.
They had their time with the AFC East quarterback, too, Ryan Fitzpatrick. Only team he hadn't played for is the Patriots. So... there's time, right? There's time.
It's still time. Yeah, exactly.
But can I say what about Buffalo? I do. Franchises like this and cities like this, I do root for. I root for. I naturally go to lean toward an underdog, and I would just like to see Buffalo breakthrough. I like to see a breakthrough. Because okay. even on the Scott Norwood thing, shame on people for jumping on Norwood. 47-yard field goal on grass, that was a tough kick. Hey, thanks for watching Brother From Another on YouTube. Make sure you hit subscribe before you leave and be sure to watch us 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Time on Peacock. Appreciate you.